My mother would sing songs with us all, and we would make harmony in the whole bit, and this went on continuously. The brothers, they were so great at it. My father was a musician. He played the guitar. My brother Tito would play his guitar when he left home. And he didn't particularly care for that because my father didn't know that he was playing it. Had he known, he would have had the worst beating ever, probably. They alternated. Jermaine and Michael as lead singers. Berry Gordy had this idea of put the little one up front. And Michael, of course, took the floor at that point and said, okay, I'm the leader. But he was a natural-born leader, though. As long as I can remember, he's always had a mind of his own. Well, there he goes to New York, and he meets with Sidney Lumet, who was the director, and they liked him. I think we're gonna use this kid. They liked him, and they said, okay, you're gonna be the scarecrow the whole bit. So Michael and I moved to New York together, and he starts filming The Wiz every day, and just the two of us in New York all alone. It was quite different because we'd never been away from home, and it was our first time staying together away from home. So we stayed there until the completion of the film.
The Wiz. He's on down the most dazzling road in town with Diana Ross, Michael Jackson.
We enjoyed it. We grew up a great deal being alone in New York. And I think doing The Wiz is what made Michael great. I think I want to go solo now. Having worked with Quincy and New York from The Wiz, when he decided to do a solo album, that's who he petitioned. It's like, okay, you're the guy. The Moonwalk was a dance that the kids were doing on the streets. And Michael came along later, and he had a guy by the name of Jeffrey Daniels to teach him to do the Moonwalk. And Jeffrey taught him to do the Moonwalk, and he was good at it. And when he did it, everybody saw it and just thought this was the most wonderful thing they had ever seen, not really knowing it was a dance that was already out there. Of course, you have swans, and you have doves, and you have the fish, and you have the snakes, and you have the llamas, and you have the giraffes, and you have cougars, tigers. And we had Bubbles. Michael would always say, Bubbles, go to bed. And he would go in and he'd get his pajamas, he'd put his pajamas on. And after he puts his pajamas on, he'd go brush his teeth. Then after that, he goes, Bubbles, I said, which he hated to do, go to bed. Bubbles, I said, go to bed. And Bubbles was like, phew. The trainers always had a problem with Bubbles because they came over one day and said, this monkey is wild. He can kill you. He can slap you and knock you out, which he could, of course. He had so much power behind his slap. However, Bubbles had this power. But it was very strange because we never knew how he would react. So when my brother Jermaine had his children, they were just infants. And we said, oh my, what's Bubbles gonna do? You guys, don't let him touch it, don't. And he comes over and he sees the baby. And he comes in the room and he goes, ah! And he, like, his face goes, and he sees the baby and he walks over to him and he kisses him on the forehead. And then he takes his finger and starts rubbing his forehead. And then he takes it out of her arms and he does like this. And starts rocking it and starts kissing it. And then he walks out of the room. And Michael goes, no, no, no. Let him do it. He knows what he's doing. Michael is so successful and he's accomplished so much in his life that I personally feel that it has led him down a very lonely road. And I feel for that. A lot of times we don't realize that we're so lonely or sad for that matter because we get so engrossed in our work and we bury ourselves in this and we get lost. We lose ourselves. Invincible sold 9 million copies, perhaps more today. 9 million copies. That's more records than any artist out there today is selling, any top artist. So Michael is still doing very well. He's just not doing what Michael Jackson does. He's not selling 60 million. In my heart, I truly believe that he will be vindicated. But I don't want to see it happen again.